Father, if it is possible for you to take this cup away, but let your will be done and not my will. So this was our conversation. I was of the idea that Christ had an option of not dying. That is why he prayed that, Father, let your will be done and not my will. And then my friends were of the opinion that Christ didn't have an option, that he was destined to die, and mimi nilikubali hiyo. So swali yangu ilikuwa, did Christ have an option ama hakuwa na option?
Fantastic question. Did Jesus have an option of dying? Jesus was a man, and he was God. He was God, but he borrowed the human body so that he can die for human beings. So he went through all things that men go through. Jesus was tempted like you. Are we together? I can't hear you. Are we together? So vile wewe unaangalianga msichana unasikia kuconnect. Pia Yesu amewaisikia kuconnect. Akiwa kijana alikuwa tempted Bluetooth connect. But Bible inasema he was tempted in all ways, but he did not sin. That's what the Bible says. He was tempted in all ways. Watu wa media nikisema scripture mnaweka. He was tempted in all ways like us, but he did not sin. Are we together? Are we together? Are we together? That is what makes the gospel really beautiful. It's not really the divinity of Jesus, but also his humanity. The fact that God agreed to become a man. Are we together? And so when it came to obeying God, to obeying his Father, he had a choice. Just like you have a choice. And your man alisema, if it is possible. Sini kweli? Kwa sababu, what was his will? Yeah, his will was not to die, so that he will not be separated from his Father. Because when Jesus accepted not to die, but to be imputed our sins, hata kabla ya death, mahali alikubali the cup was not just death, it was the imputation of sin. Kwa sababu akiomba hiyo prayer, hakuwa amearrestiwa. So at that point, he was not a lamb that was carrying sin. But the moment he agreed to be arrested and to be put on the cross, before he died, all the sins of human beings came upon him. And at that point, akasema, Eloi, Eloi, my father, why have you forsaken me? So Jesus was not really against dying, because he wants to obey his Father. But he didn't want to be separated. He had never been separated from his Father, ever. Since before time began. This was the first time. So hakuwa anataka. So to answer you, he had a what? A choice. Yesu angezaliwa na amue aoe, ajenge nyumba na aishi. He had a choice. That is why sometimes unaenda kumuworship unaanza kulia. Because he made the right choices for you. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Si aliona wasichana warembo? Angeamua aoe na ajenge nyumba, alikuwa carpenter, aunde viti, wakae huko. Are we together? But he stuck to his purpose. May you stick to your purpose. Nasema may you stick to your purpose. Kama msichana hayuko in your purpose, wacha naye aende. Kama mwanaume hayuko, you understand what I'm saying? Wewe hapa kuna watu wanakaa wako heartbroken. I'm saying, kama mwanaume hayuko kwa your purpose, wacha aende. Shake your neighbor, ambia jirani yako achana aende, achana yeye. Question 2.
How, like, the moment you're ministering to someone, like you're winning a soul, not many accept you and some tend to drive away. How can you, like, persuade them that where you're taking them is it's the right direction?
Okay, awesome. Let us appreciate her.
Praise God.
Amen.
So yesterday, tukiwa compel, there is a man who approached me and Tilda.
Okay.
So haongei So me, I actually thought anataka kukua compelled. Jua tu wana reflect ama kwanza ni tunapea na loan. Because those were the questions we were getting. So this guy, jua ungei, nika umpea paper, awandike. Akaniambia, akaandika, I want you, you're beautiful. So na tunajaribu kumwambia, I want Jesus. No, ananifanya hivi.
Yeah, not Jesus, anataka wewe.
So me, I ran. Juu na try kukua ni God, but... But people laughed at me, lakini mimi nataka kujua, when you find yourself in such a scenario, what do you do?
Yes,
praise God.
Amen.
So, mimi nimekuwa mostly surrounded by Muslims.
Uh-huh.
Na, they sold out winning souls, making disciples and raising leaders. So we have to win the souls first, right? And how do I start with the Muslims? And I've had so much arguments and debate about them saying their religion is better than ours and all that. Yeah. So how do I start to win a Muslim soul? Because they are the ones who are surrounding me.
Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Thank you. How do you persuade people when you are... Ukienda inje kuongelesha watu wa ukoke. How do you persuade them? Now, that is a whole topic. But basically, it is not your part to convict people. It is the Holy Spirit that makes people get born again. And anawaongelesha. Your part is to share the gospel. The Bible does not say that the end will come when everybody is born again. The Bible says the end will come when the gospel has been preached to every corner of the world. Our assignment is not to make anyone get born again. You can preach the whole day, nobody gets born again. Ask Jeremiah. Jeremiah was a prophet of God. In his time, not in one day, his whole life was a rejected prophet. Do you know Lamentations? Anjo Lamentation? Anjo Lamentation inamaanisha nini? What is the meaning of Lamentation? Crying. That is the book of Jeremiah. Because his whole ministry, he was doing what? Crying. He was lamenting. Are we together? So be sure that you will be rejected. Be prepared to be rejected. Be prepared kurushiwa mawe. Are we together? Like to answer you. Be prepared unaenda kupreachia mtu gospel anakukatia. Be prepared for that. And it is okay. It is not your mistake. Are we together? But there are things we can do to help people receive the gospel. And there's a time I taught this. Hii nimeshafundisha nikamwambia you can garnish the gospel. Kama the gospel ni nyama, do you know garnish? You can garnish the gospel. Na niliwaambia, how do you garnish the gospel? By your conduct. If you are not dressed well, don't go to win souls. Because you are misrepresenting Jesus. Sinu kweli? Yeah. Awezi enda na kaskat kadogo hapo. Wakuja, wataanza kukatia. Sinu kweli? Yeah. Usiende umejipaka paka huku, unakaa kama ukuta ya graffiti. Umejaa huku kila kitu. You will be rejected. Are we together? Don't go na maringo. You are smart, but unaringa. Hi guys. Can I preach to you? Paul alisema, I have become all things to all men, so that by all means, I might win some. Not all. Anasema, I have become all things to all men, so that by all means, I may win some. Be willing to adjust when you are going to win souls. Hata kama unapenda makeup, reduce. Because that makeup is a hindrance. Shake the lady next to you. Tell her, adjust. How do you win Muslims to Christ? Now listen to me. This is very... there's a lot of detail to that question. Are we together? If you can hear me, let me see your hand. Tuko hamwe. How do you win Muslims to Christ? Number one. If you have not taken time to understand the word of God, don't go to win Muslims to Christ. Because they will win you to become a Muslim. Tutakutuma ukiitwa Kamau, tukupata unaitwa nani? Abdallah. Saturday afternoon compel umeshaitwa Abdalla. Because hao wanajua kile wanasema from their side, wewe hauja take time to understand the gospel. You don't need to understand the whole Bible, but understand the gospel. Paul aliambia Timothy, study to show yourself approved. Are we together? So usiende vita kama hujajipanga. Be ready to answer any question. Be ready to answer any question. So unafaa ujiulize, Muslims huwa wanauliza nini? Huwa wanasema nini? You study, then you prepare answers. So my point is prepare. Now I can take you through what they ask, but now that is a different class. But don't go if you are not tell them to prepare. Whether it is Muslim, Hindus, prepare by knowing the word. Number two, through prayer. Prepare through prayer. Acts 16:14 inasemaje? And Lydia, whose heart God had opened, took heed of everything that Paul taught. Ndio huyu mwanamke anaitwa Lydia akubali the message of Paul. God had to first open her heart. So you need to pray and say, Lord, when I go to meet Abdul, open his heart to hear me. Number three, be patient and allow the Holy Spirit to work. You can prepare, you can pray, but they have a choice to get born again or not. People don't get born again because you have prepared. Even if you prepare your best, they can still say no. Are we together? Your part is to share the message.
Pastor Uwesema, after praise and worship, that you are not lied to. You gain salvation, sindio? Kuna a friend of mine alipost a while back that kuna watu ni protesters na hawajui wana protest nini. So, unajui ile swali ya what are we? Sasa kama sold out. What are we?
That's a good question. What are we? So as this sold out ministry, we are a church for young people. Sold out inamaanisha aje? Sold out. Completely committed. Devoted. Invested. And engaged to a cause. Respond vizuri. To have no reserve about the decision you are making. To be willing to go anywhere. Simseme wow. Do anything. And give up everything. In order to achieve your goal by any means necessary. In the meaning, you are sold out. Totally. So we are sold out to Jesus. And we are willing to do whatever Jesus wants us to do. To go anywhere. Ah, you are not understanding what I'm saying. That is why I told you that we are opening a branch in Tanzania. Sasa angalia kuna watu hapa wajamini. That's why I'm saying we are going far in the name of Jesus. Na nyinyi ndio mtakuwa pastor. Shake your neighbor. Yesu akituambia twende tufungue church Nigeria, one of us will go there. You will go there with your wife, with your husband. Tell them I'm sold out. What are you saying? Yeah, I'm sold out to Jesus. Whatever he wants me to do is what I do. Akiniambia ni kudump na kuacha. No, shake your neighbor. Mwambie I'm sold out. Yeah, our scripture ya kufungua sold out in 2020 ilikuwa Galatians 2:20. Ah, you're missing what I'm saying. Tukianzisha sold out 2020, our scripture was Galatians 2:20. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me. Our motivation is the love of God. We are devoted because he first loved us. The reason why we go everywhere is because we were first loved by God. Na saizi tumejiachilia, it is no longer I who lives. So I'm committed. Shake your neighbor, tell him I'm committed. I'm devoted. Are we together? Next question.
How do you challenge Christianity is a 8-month thing?
Ukiambiwa Christianity ni ya mzungu, ililetwa na mzungu, how do you challenge it? Pia mimi ni mzungu, that's a good answer. Ukiambiwa Christianity ni ya wazungu, what do you respond? Ukiambiwa Christianity ni ya wazungu, mwenye anakuambia ajui kenye anasema. Because before wazungu wakuja Africa, Jesus alikuwa hapa Egypt. Ah, you are missing what I'm saying. Christianity haikuanza na wazungu. I mean, we had disciples coming this side before they went to America. So hiyo swali imeisha hivyo. Christianity did not begin there. Actually, hata kama hawataki kuamini wa Afrika, ilianzia Israel. It's not for mzungu. Are we together? But ilikuja Africa before iende kwa wazungu. Ama mkusoma the Ethiopian eunuch? Si alikuwa hapa, alikuwa anasoma Isaiah hapa juu. Anaweza tembea hapa. Akapatana na nani? Na Philip. Philip akamuelezea gospel, akambatiza. I mean, there were so many Christians here in the time of kina Apostle Paul. Kabla ya wazungu kupata Ukristo. Ethiopia kumejaa old churches. Ukiingia huko wanazipata za kitambo. Are we together? So that one is a lie. So there is no debate. Next question.
Similar to that, why did God focus on Israel and Egypt and abandon the rest of the world?
Why did God
focus
on Israel and Egypt? And Kenya ikaambiwa ye.
If I read it verbatim, itakuwa even worse.
Can I tell you why? Are you here? There is something called divine election. Are we together? Divine, where God chooses who he chooses. And you cannot ask him because he's who? God. Divine election. Of course, he did not choose Israel. He chose Abraham. Then Abraham had a son, Isaac. Isaac had a son, Jacob. He gave that son the name Israel. Then he began a nation with him. That's just a better way of putting it. But now, I can still ask a question and say, why did he choose, even if he did not choose Israel your time, why did he choose that land? Mbona hakuleta Jacob hapa Kenya? Divine election. Divine what? Election. Are we together? Next question.
Okay, the Bible says that the lesser is blessed by the greater. So why did he bow or pay tithe to that king? Alikuwa ametoka ku defeat 5 kings, so alikuwa na uwezo wa ku defeat that king.
Yeah.
And then the second question is, so in that question I want to know who is Melchizedek.
Okay.
And the second question, and why is Jesus, mbona aliamua kukuwa high priest in that order? Because there was already the order of Levi. Mm-hmm. And the second question is in the book of Romans 12 verse 2, which says, be transformed by the renewal of your mind. So we know the mind is being transformed because it says so. And we know the spirit has already been saved because you are a new creation. So what is being transformed?
All right.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So there's a time when Abraham went to war with his men, his trained men, and he went and fought 5 kings. Can you imagine? Well, that's a good place to say wow.
Wow.
Abraham alienda akafight how many kings? And he took their spoils. Everything akakuja nayo. Akirudi home, akapatana na a man. The man was carrying bread and what? Wine. Remember wine, sindio? Abraham akaangalia kila kitu amepata from the 5 kings, akatoa 10%. Hapo ndo tunaona tithe. Akatoa a tenth of everything. Akapatia huyo mtu. Huyo mtu alimpatia Holy Communion. Alright? Are we together?
Yes,
his name inamaanisha the King of Jerusalem, the King of Peace, the King of Righteousness, Melchizedek. Bible inasema, he was a man without father, without mother, without origin. So hakuwa na baba, hakuwa na mama, hakuwa na origin. Anaitwa nani? Melchizedek. Then years later, the writer of Hebrews anatuambia that Jesus, who is now our high priest, amekuja not in the order of Aaron, amekuja in the order of Melchizedek. Remember, it is priests that walikuwa allowed kuchukua your offering. Now before the law, because Abraham existed before the law. Before the law. So Abraham had tithe when tithing was not a law. Just for people who say we should not tithe because tithing was of the law. That is wrong. Tithing existed, pre-existed the law. Are we together? So why is Jesus, because now Jesus is our high priest now. Yeah. Uko juu, of course heaven is your Jew, but what's the only point Jew? Uko juu heaven, kuna Holy of Holies, kuna altar, kuna mercy seat. Na kwa hiyo mercy seat, Yesu ako hapo, na kuna damu yake hapo. Na Yesu anakuombea kila siku. Do you know that Jesus prays for you? He is your intercessor. He prays for you every day. Are we together? So as a priest, akiwa huko juu, because it is priests who used to go deep to the Holy of Holies. It is the high priest. Now Jesus as a high priest anasema, I am not a high priest like Aaron. I am a high priest like Melchizedek. Why? Why? Hebu shika jirani yako usikie kama kichwa imekuwa moto. Nasikia hapo sikia ameanza kutoa moshi kwa masikio. Unajua CPU imeanza kushika moto. Jesus, are we here? Jesus is our high priest in the order of faith, not in the order of the law. And Abraham was justified by faith. Are we together? Are you understanding what I'm saying? When the law came, unajua nani alipeana law? Moses. Si ni kweli? When the law came, you became just, right, good before God if you have obeyed the law. That is a simple way of saying it. But Abraham akiwa hakukuwa na law. So how was he right before God? Bible inatuambia he was justified by faith. Bible inasema he believed and it was counted to him as righteousness. That is the same thing we do today. You're missing what I'm saying. Today we are not justified by the law. We believe in what Jesus did and we are counted as right before God. Are we together?
Yes.
Are we together?
Yes.
I think that's good. So who was Melchizedek? In the Bible, there is what we call Christophany. It's the Old Testament appearances of Christ. For example, there's a time when Joshua walikuwa kwa vita. Na Joshua akitembea peke yake, akiwa ameshika sword. In Joshua chapter 5, I believe uko chini somewhere, akapatana na mtu. Na huyo mtu pia ameshika sword. Na walikuwa wanataka kuingia Jericho. Joshua akamuuliza, "Are you for us or are you against us?" Nikumalize saa hii. Huyo mtu akamwambia, "No." Joshua anamuuliza, "Are you for us or against us?" Huyo mtu akasema aje? Then Joshua kashikanisha, "My goodness, this is God." Melchizedek. There are men who appeared to Abraham. There were three. Yoswali yake. There were three. One of them was God. Yen alisema, "How can I hide this thing from my friend?" Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yes.
I think hapo tuko sawa. In a basic way, sindio? Another question. So Mkristo anakuwa transformed. Which part of the Christian? I think it may share so many times. Three people come here, the three of you. Stand here. The renewing of your mind. Do not be conformed to this world. Usikuwe na pressure ya kukua kama watu wa hii dunia. But be transformed by the renewing of your mind. A human being akona spirit, soul, body. Spirit, soul, nangoja mseme na mimi. Spirit. Ukiokoka, which part gets born again? So listen, are you a spirit, are you a soul, or are you a body? So you are a spirit, you have a soul, you live in a... So which part was born again? This is who you are. So when somebody is not born again, this part is dead. Are we together? When you get born again, it is rejuvenated. It is born again. Hallelujah. Mnakumbuka Nicodemus kwa John chapter 3. Aliuliza Yesu, shall I go back to my mother's womb? Kwa sababu Yesu alimwambia you must be born again. Yeye akafikiria ni the body. Yesu akamwambia, Niko, acha hizo. Kuokoka si body, ni the spirit. Are we together? Na hapa, when you get born again, Bible inasema, as he is, so are we. Can you imagine? Wewe na Yesu mnafanana. Shake your neighbor. Mwambie kama umeokoka, wewe na Yesu mnafanana. Ndiyo maana, Holy Spirit sasa anaweza ishi ndani yako. Yeah. Otherwise, if you are not perfect, he cannot live in you. This is where the Holy Spirit is. Bible inasema, he that is joined to the Spirit is one spirit with him. So, come up, Paul. So now Paul is the Holy Spirit. Are we together? So, keti chini. Apana si ati Paul is the Holy Spirit. It's because of what I want to do. I want you to hug. Wisdom. Sasa, this is how you are. You now. This is how you are with the Holy Spirit. You are tight. The Holy Spirit is your closest friend. Closest is the Holy Spirit. Ameona tabia zako zote chafu na bado amekushikilia. Si hata wewe unajijua. Na bado amekushikilia hivi. Bible inasema, we are sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. We are sealed. Yani, unajua vile unaweza unaacha kitu, but utaki kuwe tampered with. So you put a seal. So when Jesus left, so that he can protect his bride, he sealed you with the Holy Spirit. Can you imagine? So he part is protected. Are we together? So when you got born again, jina sin, kuna verb na kuna noun. Simunajua nouns na verbs? Okay, mimi nilikuambia usipende masomo. Sasa, mnajua verbs na nouns? So sin, kuna noun na kuna verb. What is a noun? What is a verb? So sin, the noun, was taken away from you when you got born again. But we are still sinning, the verb. So what did Jesus take away? The noun, the nature of sin. The thing that produces sin was taken away. The nature. Na ukapatiwa a new nature. 2 Corinthians 5:17, if anyone is in Christ, is a new... Tell me about you are new now. New. But, there's a problem. When you used to go to the club, you remember when you used to go to the club? When you used to sleep around, you remember when you used to sleep around? I mean, situacha kujifanya, atujawai fanya hizi vitu. There were codes, like computer codes. There were codes of sin that were stored in your soul. Because your decisions don't come from here. Hapa kwa soul, ndio kuna mind, will, and emotion. Mind, will, and? Mind, will, and? Mind is for thinking. We think with the mind part of the soul. The emotion part is for feelings. And the will part is for choices. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So your choices. Wacha niende kwa Jose, saa tatu usiku. Ati ameniambia naumwa na kichwa. That very foolish choice. That choice that is very foolish is from the soul. So kwa sababu huyu hakuokoka. Sio Morris, the soul. Because the soul was not born again, it is still coded to sin. Kodi yake bado ni sin. Because that is all it knows. Hii bado iko na insecurity. Sijui niko shy. Sijui I am phlegmatic. All those things are here. In your soul. Are we together? And this is the what? The body. So, Mungu alikuwa anajua, there is no way these people can change here if I don't change here. Because they will have the nature of sin. So akakuja akaondoa the nature of sin and he united with you. So that now by the help of the Holy Spirit, this man can be empowered to make better choices. When he makes better choices, huyu, kwa sababu nani ndiye akona mkono ya kuiba? Mkono haiko hapa. Mkono iko wapi? Mdomo ya kusengenya iko wapi? Private parts ziko wapi?
Ah, zegadei.
Everything is here. So, lakini huyu, si yeye ana make choices. Your body does not make choices. The choices are made where? Here. So when this one makes the right choices, this one will act right. When this one acts right, your family is well. The nation is well. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So Bible inasema, hata kama umeokoka, bado utaendelea kutenda dhambi. Ah, simwacha kujifanya na nyinyi mnakuwa mnatenda dhambi. Si ni kweli? Na unashanga, mbona natenda dhambi na nimeokoka? Is because of the code of sin in your soul. So how do you stop sinning? Kwa body, you change the soul. How do you do it? Romans 12 verse 2. The renewing of the mind is by the word of God. Because it was coded by information. It will be recorded by information. Wow. Are we together? Tuko pamoja. Ule mwenye amefanya programming, unajua how you write programs, how you come up with the programs. It is codes, it is information that is organized in a particular way. Yeah. So lazima huyu aanze kupata new information. Kila siku anasoma Bible, Sunday anakuja church. The more the information in him is changed, the more their actions will change. Somebody appreciate Jesus.
The Bible says that we are the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus, right? Now, the question is, can a Christian become unrighteous again?
Unaweza rephrase bado kama can someone lose their salvation?
Yes, exactly.
All right, can someone lose their salvation? That's a good question. Sini kweli? So, hapa palikuwa na three people, spirit, soul, and shake your neighbor, ask your neighbor, are we together? So, which part was born again? Which part is being born again? Which part will be born again? Yeah. The body will be born again. It will be saved. Bible inasema, we have been saved, we are being saved, and we shall be saved. Shall be in your body. You'll be given a new body. Eh, ukienda, itakuwa changed. Yeah. Yutu tu sports, tunakusumbua, hatutakuwa.
Ah.
Are we together? But this part is being saved. But this part is who you are. Now, nilikuwa nime address your question some time back. Which part of you here is righteous? The spirit. Sini kweli? Which part is being made righteous? Are we together? Now listen to me. Righteousness is a gift. You did not earn it. You did not. What did you do to become a sinner? Let me ask you that question. You were born. How kufanya kitu kakua sinner? David anasema in Psalms 51, I was born in iniquity. Vinye tu ulizaliwa kwa hii dunia. Mtoto, nani ameshaifundisha mtoto kudanganya? Hakuna. Kadogo tu kanalamba sukari na kanaficha. Unashangaa? What is happening? Na kanasema akajalamba. Kwa sababu dhambi iko ndani yake. So you did not do anything to become a sinner. Sini kweli? People are not sinners because they sin. People sin because they are sinners. Because you are born a sinner. That is why you are sinning. Are we together? So if you did not do anything to become a sinner, what should you do to become righteous? If you did not do sin to become a sinner, why do you want to do a righteous thing to become righteous? Are we together? If your righteousness is pegged on you doing something right, then you have earned it. Na Bible inasema, our righteousness is not by works. It is by faith. Are we together? But if you are indeed born again, kama umeokoka ya ukweli, this is how you know you are born again. You hate sin. Kama hauchuki dhambi hujaokoka. But pastor, nilisema ile prayer, you did not mean it. Somebody that is born again, the first sign is you sin, but you hate it. I wish you were here. Because that nature that entertained sin has been taken away. Ni kama nguruwe na kondoo zikiingia kwa matope. Nguruwe ina dance kwa matope. Lakini kondoo inaamka haraka. Yeah. Because kondoo haina hiyo nature ya uchafu. Are we together? So can you lose your righteousness because you have lied? No. Otherwise, who among us will go to heaven? Tukue serious. Nani ataenda? Juu pia mimi sitaenda. Ni nani huyo Mungu akiexamine works zake? Your works akuexamine uende heaven. Mimi sitaenda. Natafuta tu kanini, ka fridge, ka soda, hell, kabaridi, straight. Juu hakuna kwenda heaven. Do you know Bible inasema, if you break one law, you are guilty of all. If you break one, you are guilty of all. Yani, ukidanganya, we ni muuaji. Ukidanganya, umelala na mtu wa bibi. Aye. Do you think the standard of God is the standard of your cousin? Mungu, when you break one, you are guilty of all. Angalia James 1 or 2. When you break one, you are guilty of all. Ati, I have only have one sin. Now you are guilty of all sins. Sasa nani ataenda? That is why we need Jesus. Bible inasema, he did not come to abolish the law. He came to fulfill the law. Yesu haku sin. He was righteous by his works. And now you can access the Father by the righteousness of Jesus. So he gave you his righteousness and he took your sins. That is what happened on the cross. He gave you his righteousness. Alikuambia, mimi nimeishi na sijasin, chukua rekodi yangu mzuri, leta yako mbaya. And because of your bad record, can you imagine you are very bad record? Tell your neighbor, you are bad record. Because of your bad record, God could not look at his son the same way. He forsook him. And Jesus died. But guess what? You are missing what I'm saying. Do you know what happened? When you gave him your bad record and he died, he did not stay under there. Your bad record could not keep Jesus in the grave. He defeated sin. I'm saying he defeated sin. Do you know when all our sins zilikalia Yesu? All our sins. Do you know when they sat on him, he did not die? Akukufa. Because kama Yesu angekufa, kama angeko kwa cross akufe, hatunge kuwa sure kama the sin imepata enough offering. Are you not understanding what I'm saying? In the Old Testament, walikuwa wanaeka offering kwa altar. And then moto inakuja, ina consume all the offering, na moto inabaki. So inamaanisha the judgment of God has remained, the sacrifice is not enough. But when Jesus was on the cross, all the judgment of God came. Every sickness, all the judgment came and he still remained there. Akachukua yote. To mean that the sacrifice is greater than... I wish I was talking to two people. That is why sasa akasema, aya naona ni kama skufi. And he gave up his spirit. Yesu hakuuliwa na dhambi. He was greater than the sin. Now let me ask you a question. Where are your sins? they are not with you because you have his righteousness. They are not with him.
Ah.
Oh, pastor, you know I have a very bad past. I have 72 exes. Listen, all your sins. Shake your neighbor. Tell your neighbor you can smile. You can smile. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is why my favorite scripture, sasile na feel mini mwenye dhambi, ni Apostle Paul. Anasema, receive us because we have wronged no man. Ah. Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul. Do you know Apostle Paul was a terrorist? Na naambia watu, receive me because I have wronged no one. Ah. Apostle Paul hujakosea mtu? No, he understood. As far as the east is from the west. Hallelujah. So wanakuambia wewe unajua umelala na watu 100. Ah, relax, 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 relax. As far as the east is from the west. Are you understanding me? Aijalishi nimefanya nini? I am the righteousness of God. Sasa unaona Wafarisayo wale wenye hawana dhambi wametulia. Sisi wenye tuko na dhambi, we are excited. Are you understanding me? Shake your neighbor, tell your neighbor you are the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. Now, what if a Christian that is born again, leo aseme, I don't want Jesus. A Christian that is not born again, that is born again, the righteousness of God. Amke tu aseme, I don't want Jesus. Jesus is fake. I'm now living for Buddha. Now my God is a cow. Okay? Two possibilities. Number one, he was never born again. Hii nilikuwa nimesha teach vizuri. Sometimes nikawaambia Bible inasema in the book of the epistles of John, is it first John, they went from among us because they were never part of us. Inamaanisha huyo mtu he was doing Christianity, because you can be in church and you are not born again. You can be living as a Christian hata umecopy our tongues
zegede,
but you are not. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So such people, utaona mtu ame turn. Ama Hindu. Hey, that was such a... Hata ungepitia kwanza atheist to kingia hivi. It's because they were never born again from the beginning. Are you together? Yeah. Aya. Theoretically, if you that is indeed born again, truly born again, says Jesus, I don't want you, will you go to heaven? No, because you have a choice. But it is impossible. I'm telling you, it is impossible to have a recreated spirit, to be born again and say, I don't want Jesus. Jesus is fake. You are not born again. That is our say. The reason why I'm saying this is for you to know that you are secure. What if one day I feel like I don't? You know, you will not feel it. You might feel discouraged. You might feel like God has let me down, but you will not turn. I'm telling you, you will not turn. Are you understanding what I'm saying? And I say, he sealed us. Alikusil. What if? No, you try. Try say, Sema, Yesu, I don't want you. Within 1 minute, Sema, forgive me. Try it. Try say, Sema, Yesu, sikutaki. Utasema, nyoni likuwa na joke. Yeah. Si umesha yona mtoto akisema, mtoto mdogo, wa miaka ine. Mina toka kwa hii nyumba mnipendi, anafika pale inje, anaangalia hivi. Are you understanding me? Yeah. So, it is possible for a Christian to say, I don't want God. My wife has died. My husband has died. God does not love me. It is possible for a Christian to say that. But I'm telling you, if they are born again, they are coming back. I'm saying they are coming back. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Next question.
Kuna time Moses wakimit na God alikuwa ta kumuona, but inasemekana that he was able to see the glory. Now how can you see that glory if bado pia inakuwa protected?
So Moses aliona the glory of God, alisema anataka kuona the glory of God. Exodus 33, Mungu akasema, you will not see my face, but you will see my back. Sini kweli? Media wataenda hapo. And when God was passing, he covered Moses. Kwa sababu alimwambia, nobody sees me and continues to live. If you see me, you die. Sini kweli? Then when God covered him, Moses saw something. Na tumeandikiwa what he saw. What did he see? What did he see? Now, utaenda, is it chapter now 34, the next one? Because this is 33. Enda 33 uko chini, I believe. And I will make my hand, I will take away my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face you shall not see. Now go to the next chapter. Chapter 34. Now let us see what Moses saw, so that you know what is the glory of God. And the Lord passed before him and proclaimed. So Mungu akapita mbele ya Moses na Mungu akaproclaim. Sikia kenye aliproclaim. The Lord God, merciful and gracious, long-suffering and abounding in goodness and truth. Continue. Keeping mercy for 1,000 years, forgiving iniquity. Anaendelea, anaendelea. Continue. So Moses made haste and bowed his head toward the earth and worshipped. Continue. Then he said, if now I have found grace in your sight, O Lord, let my Lord, I pray, go among us, even though we are stiff-necked people. So, anasema, I have found grace. Meaning, he has seen the back. But what was the back of God? The grace of God. The goodness of God. Are you missing what I'm saying? Are you understanding what I'm saying? How do you notice there are things when you mention them in prayer, you begin to cry? Hata kama ulikuwa too serious. When you consider the goodness, it breaks you. When you consider his grace, it breaks you. Because now you are accessing the glory of God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There's a lot we can share about the glory of God. But that is a good lesson. Are we together? So now you know what he saw. Hakuona ati mgongo ikipita. Hapana. When his eyes were opened, he was taken into the grace of God. That is what he saw. He forgives sins. Are you understanding me? Next question.
Swali lingine ni that relationship with God. And kuna part in Genesis where Abraham saw the two passengers when walikuwa na Peter. He invited them. Then within themselves, kuka kuna conversation that how be it that I will hide this thing that I'm about to do from my friend. Now, how deep do you know that you are into God's business that atakurevidia kenya nataka?
Amazing. Okay. So, Abraham was a friend of God, sindio? Na si Abraham alisema. Kama unajua sisi kusema, I am a friend. No, Mungu mwenyewe alisema. Ajua mtu anaweza sema, we ni best yake. Tungoje. Abraham mwenyewe alisema, God said, Abraham is my friend. Now, how do you become a friend of God? To a point where God talks to you, tells you secrets. No, to tell you dangers, you don't need to be friends. That is separate. Ati unaenda kukanyagwa, hiyo si lazima mkuwe friends. He loves you. He will warn you. God will warn you and he wants you through many ways. An impression in you. Kama umekuwa kuja when is the service, we have learned a lot of these things. How to hear the voice of God. So there are so many ways God can warn you. And he wants you because he loves you. But his secrets are not with people that he loves. His secrets are with his friends. Sisi wote Mungu anatupenda. But tunaweza pata akona friends wawili hapa. Yeah. So this is how you know you are a friend of God. Not because everything is good with your life. Now Abraham, alisuggestiwa alale na Hagar. Akalala na immediately. You are not understanding what I'm saying. So, I do not feel like, ama Abraham alikuwa amemwangalia before. I was like, okay, I'm married. But when you suggested aku nini, aku pinga. Sema, apu. But listen. So how was this man still a friend of God with his sins? Friends of God are interested with God. That's it. Did you pray? Did you talk to God today morning? Yeah. Do you talk to him when you go to sleep? Do you talk to him during the day? Do you ask him questions? Is it your lifestyle? If that is your lifestyle, you are his friend. Are we together? Lot was righteous. Bible inasema, righteous Lot. But Mungu ange destroy Sodom, Lot akiwa ndani. It took the intercession of Abraham. You can be righteous. You dress well, you talk well. But you're not interested with God. You pray every day, shadalagada, but you don't talk to God. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So I'm not talking about prayer. As you know prayer. I'm talking about real prayer. Real prayer is God. How are you? Yeah. Oh God, I don't want to fail you. What do you want me to do? Such conversations, those are for friends. For righteous people, zegede, zegede. Hallelujah. Kuna swali ya Danlop inahusiana na hisi, ndio? Aha. Uliza tu kiwa hapo. Amen.
Thank you. Related to hiyo swali venye God anaweza tuongelesha.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or kutuona about danger.
Yeah.
So this is about prophecy.
Mm.
Can a prophet misprophesy?
Can a prophet misprophesy?
Yes.
All right, thank you. A genuine prophet of God. Can a genuine prophet of God say something that is not true or something that will not come to pass? Something that is not true or something that will not come to pass? I want to understand because those are different.
Like prophet akuje akwambie about something.
Yeah.
Si ana prophesy.
Yeah.
Sorry. Next week,
uh-huh.
Kuna pali utaitwa kazi.
Okay.
And utafanya hivi na hivi. Because uh-huh. God amenionesha hivyo.
Uh-huh.
Then hiyo wiki inafika, mm-hmm. and it doesn't happen.
Haujaitwa. Na alikuwa amekwambia utaitwa.
Yes.
All right.
Anaweza misprofesai.
Alikuwa amekwambia something like, umesema alikuwa amekwambia ukifanya hivi.
Utafanya, like, utaitwa, uh-huh. and this is what you will do.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Good, thank you. So, there's something I taught last Sunday. All right? Last Sunday, I said that personal prophecies are conditional. All right? So, I don't want to judge, kwa sababu sijui nani alikwambia. Sitaki kusema whether alikuwa a prophet of God or not a prophet of God. But kama nitamtetea nitasema that personal prophecies are conditional. And I said something that maybe some of you missed. I said that in the scriptural examples that I used, the condition was not given. Is it kama mliona? In the scriptural examples, like Hezekiah, the condition was not given. Aliambiwa prepare your dying, and the prophet left. No condition. But Hezekiah knew that there is a condition. So he turned to the wall and began to pray. And the prophecy was reversed. So I don't want to say that kile alikwambia that you did not do your part. That is not what I'm saying. But I'm saying if he was a prophet of God, if he had God, then there is a condition that was not met. That is why I taught you about praying with the word, speaking the word. Sinukweli. Aya, number two. Listen to this very carefully. Bible inasema, we see in part, we prophesy in part. I can tell you that I see you next week being called for a job, but I don't see you applying for that job. Umenielewa? Because we see in part, we prophesy in part. So I can tell you what I'm seeing. I'm seeing you being called for a job. But if I would have taken time in the spirit, I would have seen you applying for that job. I would have seen God telling me, tell him to fast on Monday. because the fasting will activate there. But hiyo siku ngoja, I just gave a word. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So that is if I'm defending the prophet. But again, there are people who just say things emotionally. All right?
Ukifikiria sana kuhusu God, labda God alitoka wapi, kitu kaa hiyo utadeti. Sasa ni ukweli ama ni uongo?
Ukifikiria Mungu sana utaanguka ukufe. Hapana. Hapana. You will not die. Bible inasema, meditate. Think. Think about God. Now, in that question, one lesson that should have been taught in school is how to think. How to think. I'm telling you, the reason why you are crying is because of how you think. Yeah. The reason why you are stressed is not because of what you are going through. It's because of how you think. Thinking is a faculty of producing solutions, not highlighting problems. We don't think to highlight our problems. We think to manufacture solutions. But we were trained to highlight problems. So you spend the whole day, mbona aku ameniacha hivi? Mbona aku niongelesha? Mbona amenifanya hivi? You are highlighting your problems. You will kill yourself. Yeah. Thinking is a place of, I will move like this. I will escape like this. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Next question.
Why can't you be forgiven for wronging the Holy Spirit?
Why can't you be forgiven for wronging the Holy Spirit? Now, your scripture, tufungulie, inaitwa the unpardonable sin. The unpardonable sin. Tufungulie scripture, Pastor Andrew. The unpardonable, I want to show you something. Kwa nini ukikosea Holy Spirit hautasamehewa? Listen to me. Yesu wako anasema kukosea Holy Spirit. The way we think about it. Kwa sababu kwa Bible inasema blaspheming the Holy Spirit. Because kila time ukidanganya, unakosea nani? Holy Spirit. Unaeka diamond. Nasijui Zuchu. Nani mwingine? Mwani sacha kujifanya. Nani mwingine? Harmonize. Ni nani unakosea? Holy Spirit. But si umesamewa. Si unalianga na kusamea. Ni nini ukifanyia Holy Spirit hawezi kusamehea? Bible inasema blaspheming the Holy Spirit. Ndio? Matthew 12:31. Now, hapa ukiangalia the context, ile time tulikuwa tunasoma how to become a teacher, we read about biblical hermeneutics. Ni kweli? Na niliwafundisha principles of interpreting scripture. Are we together? Now, Matthew 12:31. I want you to see the context. The unpardonable sin. The context. Alikuwa anawaambia, they told Jesus that you are casting out demons by Beelzebub. Waliona Yesu akicast out devils. Wakasema, anatumia nini? Beelzebub. Yesu akawauliza, how can the devil fight himself? How can a kingdom divided against itself stand? Are we together? It is in that context ndiye aliwaambia, verse 31. In that context, aliwaambia, therefore I say to you, every sin and blasphemy will be forgiven. But blasphemy against the Spirit will not be forgiven. What was the sin of these people against the Holy Spirit? What did they do against the Holy Spirit? They attributed, are you hearing me? They attributed the works of the Holy Spirit to demons. Ah, you're not understanding what I'm saying. That was their mistake. Wanaona mapepo inatolewa kwa church wanasema ni madevo. Yesu anauliza, devo anaweza aje toa devo? What are you saying? Are we together? Holy Spirit amepatia mtu message. Preach about repentance. Preach about prosperity. Preach about healing. Watu wanasema, iyo ni ya Mungu, iyo ni ya Shetani. Are you the one that gives people messages? That is why you should not be quick to comment things that you don't know about. Are you understanding what I'm saying? If you don't understand someone's ministry, keep quiet. Am I talking to two people? the God of... Are you here? The God of Moses that prayed for people, God, don't kill them, take me to hell, is the God of Elijah who killed 50 plus 50. You understand what I'm saying? So don't put God in a box. You don't know God. Ukiona mtu anaponya watu na maji anamwagia maji, keep quiet. Ukiona watu anapatia watu handkerchief, keep quiet. Ukiona mtu anapatiana mafuta, keep quiet. You focus on what you think is right. But when you begin to say, hiyo ni kazi ya shetani, what if you are attributing something that is of the Holy Spirit to the devil? Our God is a progressive God. Are we together? Our God does not change, but his methods change. Our God does not change, but his ways change. Aliambia Abraham, sacrifice your son. Akienda kumuua akamwambia aje, don't touch your son. Are you here? Are you here? That is why Apostle Peter, who God wanted to send to the Gentiles, was not sent. Because Peter was a staunch Jew. Yeye alikuwa anaamini salvation is for the Jews. Na Mungu akamtokea one day in a trance. I believe it is Acts chapter 10 or something. Akamletea chakula zile Jews walikuwa wanaita nini? Unclean. Akaambia Peter, eat. Peter akasema, they are unclean. Mungu akamwambia, if I call something clean, don't call it unclean. But the same God alikuwa ameita hizo chakula unclean in the Old Testament. Si ati Peter alikuwa anafuata mtu mwingine, alikuwa anafuata Mungu. Mungu ndiye alikuwa amemwambia ni unclean. But sasa Mungu anakuja anasema, they are clean. Peter akakataa kukula. Ikaenda. Ikarudi tena. Peter akaambiwa kula, akakataa. Ikaenda na ikakataa kurudi. Guess what? That day Mungu akajua, I cannot send this man to the Gentiles. He went and looked for Saul, a terrorist. You can lose your ministry because of insisting on how you think God should work. Yes. Yes, yesterday nilikuwa naomba usiku na nilikuwa naambia Mungu, if there is something you want me to change, I'm ready to change. That was my prayer yesterday. Nilikuwa namwambia, I was praying, nilikuwa naambia Mungu, I don't want to be a photocopy of anybody. I know I'm not a photocopy. So I can be copying this person, inspired by this person, inspired by this person, but I'm ready to become whatever you want me to be. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So their mistake, they were calling the Holy Spirit a demon. Now, why is that wrong today? Because I'm telling you, if you are really born again, you cannot say Holy Spirit that you are a demon. You cannot say it. So don't worry about the unpardonable sin. You cannot blaspheme the Holy Spirit direct if you are born again. You cannot. Hawezi sema hivyo. Are we together? But there is something you can do na ukwe hawezi saidiwa na Mungu. And that is despising the voice of the Holy Spirit. These people were not born again. Hii time, Yesu wako amekufa. After Yesu akufe, things changed. But there is still something you can do to the Holy Spirit and your life Mungu ashindwe kukusaidia. Despising the voice of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the one who tells you what God wants you to do. If you don't listen to him, God cannot help you. Utaingia kwa shimo na useme Mungu hakukwambia. But you are despising the voice of the Holy Spirit. Bible inasema that the Spirit of God will not strive with men for a long time. Atakwambia kitu leo, akwambie kitu kesho, akwambie next week, akwambie next month, anyamaze. Kwa sababu amekuwa akikwambia uachane na huyo msichana na usikii. Ah? Okay, shake your neighbor, tell me the word is for you. Amekuwa akikwambia uachane na huyo jamaa na usikii. Unaendelea kumtetea. Ati anapenda God. Yeye unipatia offering. Yeye ni spiritual. Baba yake ni pastor. At some point, do you know what will happen after some point? Utaacha kusikia kama kufanya hiyo kitu ni mbaya. The day unafanya dhambi na hausiki kama kufanya dhambi ni mbaya, begin to cry because the Holy Spirit has gone quiet. I'm saying the day una watch pornography as a Christian na ulikuwa unasiaga vibaya na saizi hausiki, you are dead.
Pastor anaweza enda hell na mwizi anaweza anaweza enda. Anaweza enda mbinguni, mwizi anaweza enda mbinguni.
Yes, 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 yes. Bible inasema that many will say, I healed in your name. I cast out devils in your name. Na Yesu atawaambia, depart from me, Matthew chapter 7, for I never knew you. Kwa hivyo nani ndio huwa wana cast out devils church? Ni pastors. Si members tu wako huko nyuma. Ni watu wamekaa hapa. Leo watu wako mbele wanasikia kwenda nyuma. Hiyo scripture inaongelelea leaders in church that are doing miracles, but Jesus does not know them. Be careful not to confuse serving God by being known by God. Hizo vitu ni tofauti. Be known by God, then serve God. Ndio maana alisema in Mark, is it Mark 3:14 or what? That he called the 12 to be with him and to send them. Not to send them. Aliwaita wakae na yeye, ndio wawatume. Si ati awatume ndio wamjue. Jua Mungu kwanza. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Tell your neighbor, be known by God. Know God. So, it is possible for a pastor to go to hell, and many will go to hell. Because most of them are not born again. They don't have a relationship with God. And it is possible for a thief to go to heaven. Amekuibia, ameenda, ameshikwa. Ametolewa nguo. Wameanza kumrushia mawe. Na akarealize, I cannot escape. Na akiwa hapo anapigwa na mawe, anaambia Jesus, forgive me. I'm a sinner. Receive me in heaven. Because of how God loves people, he made salvation so easy. Are you missing what I'm saying? Kwa sababu ya vile Mungu anapenda binadamu, alifanya kuokoka ikue rahisi sana. Mpaka kulikuwa na thief kwa cross, a thief on the cross. Mmoja akaambia Yesu, if you are the son of God, si ujisaidie. But yule mwingine akamwambia, we nyamaza, can't you see this man is innocent? Akamwambia, remember me. Yesu akamwambia, today. Are you hearing me? So some of you mtaingia hivi heaven, udhani umeingia hell. Juu ya mwenye unapatana naye kwa gate. Kwa sababu alikuwa anakuibia. Anakuambia, relax, tuko huku. Kuja nikutembeze bana. Hallelujah. Heaven itakuwa na surprises. Hell itakuwa na surprises. There are many people wameokoka kwa deathbed. Many people wameokoka wakienda kufa. Are we together? Yeah. Wengine wakiwa kwa koma, wameamka, wakaokoka, wakadai. Yeah. So you'll be surprised. Some of these unasomanga sijui Nebukadnezar, sijui Pharaoh, utawapata huko.
Hey.
Hey. Some of them utawapata tu huko wanazunguka. Si Nebukadnezar alikula nyasi. Baada ya kula nyasi alisema aje, there is no other God. Yeah. Are we together? How can I really be sure of the assignment that God has called me into? All right. Final question. Niambie wengine.
What are the sacrifices you made to become a preacher? I think you got a bad story on being a pastor.
What are the sacrifices me?
You made to become a preacher. You.
Me?
Eh, wewe. Sacrifices.
My sacrifice to become a preacher.
What are the sacrifices you made?
Ani tutaanza wapi? This is what I'll say. To serve God in any capacity is by the grace of God. It is God that calls you. It is God that empowers you. Nobody by his sacrifice can be used by God. Yeah. But as I said last week, even if God has called you, it is conditional. You have a part to play. Are we together? Yeah. So, I mean, it involves a lot of hearing God. Si ni kweli? Kuna vitu lazima uavoid. A lot. Ati kama? The day you feel like God wants to use you, that day, begin to live differently. And God wants to use all of you. All of you. God wants to use you. But if you continue to live like a common vessel, you shall be used for common purposes. But Bible inasema, whoever purges himself from the latter shall be used for, shall be made available for honorable use. Are we together? So, man, I mean, could drop some friends, some girls. Zegede. Pastor Brenda knows which ones. Kusoma usiku. I mean, nikiwa teenager, nilikuwa naandika notes kwa preacher mwenye na preach kwa TV. Different preachers niko na part yao kwa book. Hiyo time hakukuwa na internet. Okay, ilikuwa, but haikuwa accessible. Then cybers kakame, so nilikuwa naenda kwa cyber. Nalipa pesa ya 2 hours. Nasikiza messages, naandika notes kwa book. Every day, nakaa kwa cyber nikiandika notes. Yeah? Nini ingine? I mean, ilikuwa serious, eh? Kuna, kama siko home, my mama alikuwa ananichukulia notebook. Ananiandikia huyo pastors wakipreach. Because sitaki kumiss. Alikuwa anajua itaniuma nikimiss. So anachukua notebook yangu, anaandika notes hapo. So, it is like now, you see I'm teaching you, sindio? See I'm teaching you, and you're asking me, and I've not prepared for your questions. So for you to do that, angalia yo scripture ya Paul, tupatia yo scripture is our last scripture, inasema, I am who I am by the grace of God, yet not I. Anasema, I have worked harder than all apostles. Then anasema, not I, but the grace of God. It's a combination of grace and work. Yeah. A combination of the grace of God and work. Work. We are not saved by works, but we serve by works. Kukua saved is not by works. But for you to serve God is a combination of his grace and your works. And your works are products of his grace. So they are not works of the flesh. Nile nyinasema, faith without work is dead. It is the works of faith. You have to work for God. No, no. But by the grace of God, I am who I am. And his grace towards me was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than all of them. Yet not I, but the grace of God. Yani anatry is the grace, but I labored. But it is the grace of God. But I labored. Unanielewa? I mean, fasting. Apana. A lot of fasting. A lot of honor. Singekuwa pastor without my spiritual father. Hata kama ningekuwa nimesoma books ngapi. Submission. Listening to him. Akiniambia, do this, I do it. You see, listen to me. There are many people who are looking for their calling. But niliwaambia kitu some time back, I told you, before you get the specific, begin with the general. Bible inasema, Romans 12:1, the good and perfect will of God. Many people are looking for the perfect. They're ignoring the good. What is general is what introduces you to what is specific. If you want to be a preacher, a pastor, wash the church. Wash it with one heart. Do media with one heart. When he proves you in the good, he will introduce you to the perfect. Look at Jesus as a carpenter, faithfully serving his father. That is where he was being checked. If he can handle the wood of the cross. I wish I was talking to two people. Are you here?